armed men storm a Raytown house, force the occupants to the floor, and steal electronics.
KMBC 9's Dan Weinbaum has details about the robbery and what the bad guys left behind. He's live right now at Raytown Road in Gregory. Dan?
Well, the robbery happened last night around 11 o'clock in this Raytown neighborhood. The bad guys were, of course, ready to rob, but in the end, they didn't get much, and they left without everything that they took.
First time it's ever happened in this neighborhood.
William Hedrick would know, having lived in this Raytown house more than five decades. Late Monday night, watching the news, he and his wife heard noise outside.
I got up, went to the window. It was so dark, I couldn't really see anything.
He did see a car, but thought nothing of it. Didn't know a robbery was underway.
I didn't realize then that they had been robbed at gunpoint.
The next time Mr. Hedrick looked, he saw more bandits running from his neighbor's house.
And I saw three people come running around the neighbor's house up on the corner and running down towards that car.
Raytown police say two armed men burst into the house on Raytown Road around 11 at night and forced everyone to the floor.
And they told her, don't move, don't look up, don't anything, or we'll blow your brains out.
Mr. Hedrick heard the tale from his neighbor after it was over.
They asked if there's anybody else in the house, and he said, my five-year-old granddaughter is upstairs. They said, we won't hurt her. That was the only good thing that they said or did.
Police say the armed men stole the contents of a purse, two cell phones, and two TVs. But the bandits didn't think ahead as they struggled in the street with their loot.
They're trying to put a large TV in the car and it won't go.
Their getaway car, apparently too small to take the TV, they left it and fled.
Now, there were three people in the house at the time of this residential robbery. A woman, her son, and that five-year-old granddaughter. Nobody, in the end, was hurt.